What is, in your opinion, the biggest flaw of the human body? Pretty much any autoimmune disease. The body can literally kill itself trying to protect itself. Attention, task failed successfully. Agreed. I have lupus and Crohn's disease and I tell people that my immune system is a bunch of sugar hype. Three-year-olds trying to put away the dishes. My God, they try so hard but they fucking break everything. Edit. I just wanted to say thank you so much to the people who deemed my comment worthy of a medal. I love the fact that the first medal I get is because of my dysfunctional shit machine. I never thought it would blow up like this. Reading everyone's comments and stories makes me feel less alone. I wish you all the best of health, wealth and joy in your lives. How close the food pipe and wind pipe are. Allergies are, said another way, your immune system flipping the fuck out because you bumped into a peanut, dust mite, shrimp, cat, etc. The immune system is like an undisciplined army of mercenaries you keep inside your body. They can brutally slay a lot of enemies. But sometimes they just get bored and start attacking civilians. The absolute randomness in its strengths versus vulnerabilities. A person can jump from a plane, have their parachute not open and survive the impact. Or you can slip in the shower, break your fucking neck, and die on the spot. Sometimes humans roll 20s on luck and sometimes it's a 1. Edit. Thank you for my second silver ever. RN Jesus, take the wheel. Breathing hole equals food hole. Squids have it worse. Food passes through their brains. But then again, I have never heard of a squid choking to death on a bite of bruschetta. Edit. Goodness me. Thank you to all the people who informed me that we can breathe through our noses in that hour. Breathing hole is the way it is because of our evolution so we can speak. You have all really opened my eyes. Just remember the next time you are at a fancy restaurant and you find yourself choking on a bite of bruschetta, just calmly breathe through your nose and talk to the nearest waiter. I'm sure they will help you out. Of course not. The bruschetta gets soggy underwater. Edit. Something something thanks anonymous stranger something something first gold. There are many, but notably to me is how easily damaged the knee joints and the spine are. They next to impossible completely repair. Once damaged, they are never really right again. Knees make no damn sense. Our switch from quadrupedal to bipedal was to fast and fucked up a lot of things in our body. Knees being one of them. We should try tentacles or tank treads next time. If I wipe the wrong direction, I could get an infection that could spread to my kidneys and kill me. Why have we gotta wipe at all? My dog's butt is magically clean after every poop. Why can't ours do that? Though I don't envy cats who have to lick themselves clean. Fun fact, most mammals prolapse their rectum slightly when they poop. That's what helps it come out clean if they're not sick. It's a damn shame this didn't develop with humans, given our giant ass cheeks are literally our claim to bipedal fame. Though probs isn't super necessary on the og high fiber diet. Suffering from success. My schlong is more like a schlort. Hey buddy, you just got a tack on some mass. If you put 200 pounds behind a thumbtack, you're gonna do some damage. How fragile the brain is. Make it metal, and inside a metal cage. Teeth cannot repair themselves. I think, if a bone can heal back together, why the hell can't a tooth fill in a micro hole? In a natural state, teeth are pretty damn important. Edit. Just want to say thanks to all for the upvotes. It does not go unappreciated. May we all have perfect teeth forever. Yet another flaw with our teeth. Even with brushing and flossing. As you get older, you can experience bone loss that can cause an infection under the tooth, which may lead to the loss of the tooth, which is happening to me right now. The fact that there's so many things you can do to the human body without killing it. But underscore oh fuck, slept wrong and pinched a nerve, now I'm fucking paralyzed underscore. Didn't happen to me, but happened to a semi-distant family member a year ago. Edit. Holy fuck, this comment took off. Edit 2, to everybody getting paranoid in my replies. Don't worry, he was sleeping in a crowded camper on a small couch. in a very, very awkward position. This isn't a very common thing, but it does happen to people. So long as you sleep relatively well, you shouldn't have a problem, monsieur. Edit 3, apparently Reddit's full of health experts who know for a fact that you can't do this. He pinched and severed something in his spinal cord from what I remember. I'm not 100% sure if it was a nerve, but IDK what else it would be TBH. _ Either way, the point I was trying to convey was this man went from sleeping to paralyzed. So, _, oh god, I've had sleeping fears over the Reddit post of the guy who had a stroke from pulling a blood vessel in his neck sleeping wrong. I didn't until you ... just fucking made me aware of that. What the fuck? ... Put all these comments together and the human body seems like it's all just a piece of junk. It's never been the survival of the fittest, it's the survival of the good enough and lucky. Your brain replaying embarrassing moments over and over until you die. Thinks now it's doing that. Cancer. Routine processes meant to repair the body create mistakes that in turn create tumors. Humans have one of the best regenerative powers of all large mammals. Cancer is a trade-off to fast healing. So what you're telling me is Wolverine is full of tumors. Deadpool definitely is. Deadpool is a tumor. Removed. As someone who had braces for 4 years until like a week and a half ago, I agree with this. And then you have to wear retainers for a long ass time. Dentists recommend wearing them for basically every night for your whole life. Fuck sake. Don't listen to the other commenter, wear that shit every day and night. Do not regret wasting 4 years and thousands of dollars. Someone who deeply regrets not wearing their retainers more than nightly for a year and wasted 4 years of braces and thousands of dollars that we can bite the insides of our own cheeks. I'm sure plenty of you know the pain of accidentally biting down on your cheek. Edit. Thanks whoever gave the award, fam. Ectopic pregnancy. Ovaries are ovulating and doing their things. Eggs and whatnot. An egg decides enough is enough. And with the help of a hormone surge, once out of that shit, bigger and better things. So the egg literally punches out and is supposed to go straight into the fallopian tubes, get fertilized while inside the tubes, and then plant in the uterus. You would think that the entrance of the fallopian tubes would connect right to the ovary? No. The opening of the fallopian tube has these little hairs, fimbriae, that are like wacky inflatable tube men in front of sketchy used car lots, and kind of guide the egg into the fallopian tube. Sometimes the eggs don't feel like it going, and they venture off. And if fertilized, it's considered an ectopic pregnancy. It can plant anywhere in the abdominal cavity at that point. Most of the time, it will die because it has to plant in a well-vascularized region to be viable. Sometimes, it finds a good, bloody spot, and starts growing there. At that point, it's essentially a tumor. And if it can eat enough into a blood vessel, it can rupture and bleed like shit. You would think that millions of years of evolution would create a fallopian tube that opens up right to the ovary. But that's not the case. As someone who had emergency surgery yesterday for a live ectopic, I completely agree. Ectopics are rare and getting pregnant on the Mirena coil is extremely rare, but I'm proof it happens. Ladies, if you have a Mirena and pregnancy symptoms, do a test just to make sure. Catching my ectopic early is what saved my life. Also, shout out to the doctor who, even though I experienced no symptoms of an ectopic, was worried enough to book an emergency scan. And to the scan technician who very, very briefly caught a glimpse of something and chose to further explore. His diligence and her persistence prevented a very serious situation. Upvote for correct reproductive physiology. Getting tired and needing to sleep. I could have done so much shit if I hadn't had to sleep. Though really, I probably would have just still not done anything. I agree, but then I imagine longer work days. And just like that, I believe the human body requires twice as much sleep as is currently suggested. A quick tap to the testicles renders a man useless for at least a solid 5 minutes. Yeah, it's literally a critical hit. The testicles are basically the RL version of a boss weakness. Sure, you can kill it by punching it in the chest 1,000 times. Or you can take your pea shooter and hit right between the balls and cause them to collapse in. Become paralyzed for 120 seconds. Ears being so fragile and irreparable. Yes, your cochlea and your vestibular organs do not have backup blood supplies. So if you lose one to a stroke, you essentially lose hearing or balance function. Also how the cochlear hair cells do not regenerate with damage or loss, resulting in hearing loss. You can control your bladder and sphincter. Why isn't there a mechanism to hold in your period? Or better yet, why can't we have a period like we poop or pee? Just sit on the toilet for 1 to 2 minutes a month, then job done. No pain. No rashes from tampons, pads. Perfect. That would be really nice. The toilet would look like a murder scene, but it'd certainly be more convenient. Sadly, evolution lacks foresight, or a suggestion box. Asking the real question here, and I'm a dude. What's it like to be a dude with a period? Hell on earth. According to my boyfriend, disclaimer though, he doesn't get them anymore. Edit. Obligatory thanks for the silver. Y'all are awesome and I'm super grateful. Not being able to hold our breath long, quick oxygen usage. The whole oxygen thing was a mistake. Alkaline cells, that's where it is at. Nonsense. If we get a choice, we should go straight for the nuclear option. Just use the power of the sun already. Plants probably. That's something as important as the brain can stop functioning properly because of chemical imbalances. Make it a microchip. Now it can stop functioning because of electrical imbalances. My depression seconds this. The brain is like, everything okay with your life? Cool. Now I'm gonna make you feel like shit for no reason and make you lose all motivation. And oh, this just ruined your life. Have fun in therapy. Quote, hey, things are going pretty well. But what if, secretly, everyone hates you? You're getting fat. There are huge problems on the way. And by the way, your life means nothing and you'll be dead before too long. Quote, thanks brain. My personal greatest flaw in the human body has to be the immune system, is your sure. I bet a lot of you have perfectly functional immune systems. But mine has decided my gastrointestinal tract is the enemy and must be eliminated at all costs. So basically whatever programming error led to my Crohn's disease. That's the biggest flaw. I've got Crohn's too, finally in remission, but fuck that shit. We're physiologically built to have sex with as many people as possible as soon as we hit puberty. But practically, socially, and psychologically, that's a really bad idea. Moreover, fertility peaks in your late teen years. Again, great design considering that the prefrontal cortex doesn't fully mature until 25. As someone who recently had kids later in life, I think having an undeveloped prefrontal cortex would be much nicer for raising kids. This shit is insane. Teacher here, I think you're right, because instead of going, what in the actual fuck are you doing, half the time, you just join in the fun. The brain should be better secured in the head. Rattling the brain inside the skull can mess a person up. So if it was more secure, it would be safer. Use a remote server. Right now, my shin is itchy for no goddamn reason. I think that's a pretty big flaw, that an amusement park doubles as a waste management center. Let me just say that if God was a city planner, he would not put a playground next to a sewage system, monsieur. Forgetting Sarah Marshall, too many pain receptors on feet. Wheels. Definitely wheels. Tumors. Organ ruptures caused by typical functions going wrong. Many things about pregnancy, periods and ovarian cysts. Also, for women, that the urethra is so short and so close to the vagina and anus. Overstoring fat. I mean, I get hanging on to 20 pounds of the stuff just in case you need to tap into that energy, but at 50, 100, 300 pounds our bodies are still like, well, better still stock up. You never know if we'll find any food this upcoming year. It's not a metabolic issue. If our bodies were not so efficient, we probably would have died out a long time ago. The issue is that our eating triggers. Eat while the eating is good. For the highest caloric value with the lowest effort possible. We're honed over millennia where we worked for our food. Like climbing trees, chasing livestock over long distances, opening nuts with rocks work. The modern land of caloric excess would be bad enough alone, but add a shift to dangerously sedentary lifestyles and it's catastrophic. Nothing in your body is actively holding on to extra weight. It's not saying, better stock up. It's saying, there are more calories here than we need and it's more than we can get rid of through other means quickly without immediately imbalancing the system. So let's add on to the fat stores and figure out the problem later, because that's what we know how to do. It just happens that that's also a great way to get a mammal through a hard winter and get to breeding and passing on genes after. So basically the human body sees an issue then decides to brush it off and deal with it later. Sounds incredibly familiar. I'm not fat, I'm procrastinating. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.